want three columns in the investment account? Now when you invest in shares, do you earn interest on that?
Dividend.
Do you earn dividend? So instead of interest, you make the column?
Dividend.
And the last column you can make capital exit or cost. And you can make the capital as capital column, or you can make it as cost. Will write both capital and in bracket will mention cost also. So columns will slightly change. Now dividend which you earn on shares may be of two types. One is pre-acquisition, the other is post-acquisition. Now what do you mean by pre-acquisition and what do you mean by post-acquisition? Understand? See, whatever shares you purchased in the current year, whatever shares you purchased in the current year, and whatever dividend on that you get for the last year. See, last year's dividend will be given in current year?
Yes.
If company earns a profit in 15 to 16, when will it give the dividend? 16,
yes.
16 to 17. After the year 15 to 16 is over. Now you purchase the shares in 16 to 17. But when the company gives the dividend, you have those shares. You'll get the dividend. Suppose you purchase the shares in 16 to 17 on 1st May 2016. And company declares and gives the dividend for 15 to 16 on 15th May 2016. Okay, so on that date, 15th May 2016, do you have the shares or not?
Yes, sir.
So what happens? You get the dividend for last year, 15 to 16, though you were not the shareholder in the last year. You did not participate in the ownership in the last year, but still, you get the dividend on 15th May 2016 because you have the shares on that date. This is for which dividend?
Pre-acquisition.
You are getting the dividend for that period when you were not the owner of that company. You are getting the dividend for the before the acquisition of your shares. So how will you identify the pre-acquisition dividend? First of all, on the shares purchased in the current year. What is it? What is this pre-acquisition dividend? Dividend on the shares purchased in the current year. But which dividend?
Last
year's dividend. On the shares purchased in the current year. Is current year's dividend, in case if you get interim dividend, then that is post acquisition only. Okay, suppose you get dividend on 1st December, after 1st May, 1st December. In 1st December, company gives the dividend for this year, April to October, half year. That is interim dividend. Now, this is post acquisition. So, interim dividend received after purchase of the shares will be treated as post acquisition only, but you don't have such questions. You will always have questions where last year's dividend will be given to you. So you remember that what shares you purchase in the current year, on that whatever dividend you receive for last year is
pre-acquisition.
And what is this post-acquisition? Dividend on opening balance of shares. If at all you have any opening balance of shares, then that means that shares you are already having since
last year.
If you at all have any opening balance of shares, means that shares you are already having since last year. So whatever dividend you receive on that, you are already the owner also of that company in that year. So that dividend is for which dividend?
Post
acquisition dividend. So first of all, how do you identify this? Everyone is there with it. Okay. Whatever dividend you get for last year on the shares
purchased in the
current year will be pre acquisition dividend. And whatever dividend you get on the shares of opening balance will be post-acquisition. Now it's effect. See, pre-acquisition means without doing anything you are getting that profit.
Yes.
Do you get that every time?
One
time only when you purchase the shares. Mm. So it is capital profit in nature. And it will be directly recorded in last column, cost column or capital. Okay. This dividend is treated as our capital income, not as our revenue income. So where will you record this on the credit side? You will record it on credit side in which column?
Capital or cost.
Capital or cost column. Did you understand this portion, everyone?
Yes.
Okay. And post acquisition means you are also the owner of the company. And you are going to receive that dividend every year being the owner of the company. That is revenue income. So that amount you will record in the dividend column. And that amount will be transferred to profit and loss. This will be treated as a capital profit and this will be treated as a revenue profit. So what we do with this dividend? This dividend will be recorded on credit side, but in which column? Dividend column or income column. Either you can say dividend column or you can say income column. Did everyone up to understand this portion? Any confusion with this? So whatever dividend you took for last year on the shares purchased in the current year, that dividend you record in which column?
Last column.
Capital column. Okay, and whatever dividend you get on the opening balance of shares, that you record in which column?
Dividend
column. Income column. Right now. Tomorrow this chapter will get over. So the point of dividend is clear to everyone? So anyone has not clear up there yet? Now second point is regarding the bonus shares. See, bonus shares you get without paying anything. In accounts also we study when company accumulates huge reserves, then company distributes it in the form of bonus shares by capitalizing those reserves. Because basically bonus shares are the sacrifice of shareholders itself in past by not taking the dividend. So bonus shares when we get, now we have to see from investors' point of view. When we get these shares without paying anything. So we are getting the shares means it will come on debit side. But we are not paying anything for it. So it will come only nominal value column. Because we are not paying anything, cost is zero. So in cost or capital column, nothing will come. Cost is zero, in cost of capital column, nothing will be recorded. Did you understand this portion? So, right now, bonus shares will be recorded on debit side. Only in nominal value column. Bonus shares will be recorded on debit side only in nominal value column. Understood this? Also, no amount will be recorded. No amount will be recorded in capital column. Okay? Now, around 3-4 lines leave for right shares. I don't want to confuse you people by discussing that right now. Today we take up with the questions based on this dividend and bonus shares. So leave around 3-4 lines for writing the right shares. And we take up with question number 10, which by mistake I gave you as homework. Look at question number 10. On 1st April 2015, Mr. A had 20,000 equity shares in X Limited. Face value of the shares was Rs. 10 each, but the book value was Rs. 16 per share. So in nominal value, we'll record 20,000 into 10. And book value means the cost price for us. So in capital column, we will record 20,000 into 16. Yes? Is everyone clear with this? On 1st June 2015, Mr. A, capital A, purchased 5,000 equity shares more in X Limited at Rs. 14 each, so it will come on debit side. Here every transaction will not have workings. Workings will be there only for dividend and bonus, that's it. Every transaction, and when you sell it, then cost will find in the same manner. Debit capital minus credit. Then you'll have it, otherwise not. On 1st June 2015, Mr. A purchased 5,000 equity shares more in X limited at rupees 14 each. So cost will be 5,000 into 14, 70,000 and nominal value 5,000 into 10. Face value of the shares is 10 rupees. On 1st September 2015, now see this, 1st September 2015, X limited declared 15% dividend, but for the year 14 to 15. Last year's dividend is declared in September. Now here, how many shares you had in opening balance?
20,000.
That is post-acquisition dividend. So whatever dividend you earn on that 20,000 shares will be recorded in income column, dividend column. And what shares are purchased in the current year?
5,000.
Whatever dividend you earn on this, see, you purchased on 1st June. So on 1st September when dividend is declared, you'll get dividend on these 5,000 shares also.
Yes, sir.
But you are getting it for the last year 14 to 15 when you were not the owner. So you get this benefit without participating in that. That is capital profit for you. That will come in which column?
Capital
column. Opening balance of shares, 20,000's dividend will come in income column, dividend column. And purchase of shares, 5,000 shares dividend will come in capital column. Did you understand this portion? Mr. A received the same on 20th September 2015. So we have to record the things on 20th September when we have received it. Show the investment account for the year ended 30th September 2015. For the year ended 30th September, paid 31st March. 1st April you had the opening balance. Paid for the year ended 31st March 2015. So make a comment out of them. In the books of A, investment in equity shares of X limited account. Here we don't have to write any due dates in between, okay? There is no interest. Here no due dates will come in between. Columns will be nominal value.
Dividend.
Yes, dividend, or you can write income.
Capital and cost.
And capital. Do you understand this? Credit side also same columns. Date, particulars, nominal value in bracket, nothing. In dividend or income. And capital cost. So there is that. Let's see now. On 1st April 2015, Mr. A had 20,000 equity shares. In X limited, face value of shares 10 and book value 16. So we'll write it on the debit side right now. 1st April 2015. Two balance brought down. Now 20,000 shares. So 20,000 into 10. Nominal value is 2 lakhs.
Yes, sir.
Here nothing will come in income column in opening balance. There is nothing like outstanding dividend or outstanding interest. This will always be nil. In opening balance, income will always remain nil. No work needs to be done. And book value of 16 per share is given. So 20,000 into 16, 3 lakh 20,000 is the capital cost for them. Did you understand this? 20,000 into 16, 3 lakh 20,000. Anyone having any doubts up till here? All of you have recorded this?
Yes.
On 1st June 2015, Mr. A purchased 5,000 shares more in X Limited at rupees 14 each. So again, recorded on debit side, what is the date of purchase? 1st June 2015 to bank account. Now, how many shares are purchased?
5,000.
So 5,000 into 10, face value will be 50,000. Nominal value will be 50,000. And we have purchased at rupees?
14.
So 5,000 into 14. Capital column you will record 70,000. Did you understand this question, Rehman?
Yes.
Any conditions? On 1st September 2015, X Limited declared 15% dividend for the year 14 to 15. Now, dividend you will receive, all, I told you one thing earlier, interests and dividends. We always count on
face value.
Face value. So you will receive dividend on 2,50,000. Okay? Now working note 1. Dividend. See, whatever dividend you receive on opening balance of shares,
post,
that is
post
2 lakhs into what is the rate of dividend? 15%. So 2 lakhs into 15%, 30,000. This is post acquisition dividend. So whatever dividend you receive on opening balance will come in income column, dividend column. Is everyone clear with this? And whatever dividend you receive on purchase of shares current year, that is 50,000 into 15%, 7,500. That you will record in capital column because it is pre-acquisition dividend. You are receiving the dividend for the period when you were not the shareholder. Understood this? Anyone having any doubt on it? On which date did we receive this dividend?
21st
September. No? 20th September. 1st September the company declared. Read the next sentence. Mr. A received the same on
20th
September. Okay, so credit side on 20th September 2015 by bank account. In income column, what amount we will write?
Income column
30,000. And in capital column 7,500. Did you understand this? Opening balance will come in income column, purchase of shares dividend will come in capital column. Show the investment account. Everything is over. Now, as we have been doing the balancing earlier, same way, first nominal value and capital.
2,50,000, 3,90,000.
Here also, you may be given with market value, then you do the same thing. Cost price or market price, whichever is less, and if it is loss, then write the transfer the loss to P&L account. Yes. 2,50,000. 3,90,000. 2,50,000 minus 0, 2,50,000. 3,90,000 minus 7,500. 3,82,500. Did you understand this question, everyone? Then 31,316 by balance carried down. What do you aim? What time you write it here? 31,315 or 16?
16.
So 16, okay. Now, dividend, whatever is the total, that will be transferred to P&L account. So this 30,000 30,000. 31,362. Profit and loss account. So, yes. So what we do with this capital's dividend and the salary? We decrease our cost of shares. Actual cost of shares is 390. Now we get the benefit of 7,500 per last year. So whenever we consider the cost of our shares, we'll consider now 382,500. Because of that dividend what we received of last year, our cost price has increased. So that is considered as a capital profit. Did everyone understand this? Now look at question number. So very, very simple compared to the previous one. Question number 4. Page 21. On 1st April 2016, Mr. A has 20,000 equity shares in X Limited. Face value of the shares was rupees 10 each, but their book value was rupees 16 per share. Exactly same like this question. Figures are also same. On 1st June 2016, Mr. A purchased 5,000 equity shares more in X Limited at rupees 14 each. This also figures are exactly same. This is different. On 30th June 2016, the directors of X Limited announced a bonus issue. And bonus was declared at the rate of 1 equity share for every 5 shares held. So we have been doing this workings in bonus shares chapter. So 1 for 5 shares means 1 is to 5, 1 upon 5. And then we have how many shares on 30th June? We have how many shares on 25,000. Because what we purchase on 1st June, we'll get bonus on that also. So 25,000 into 1 by 5, how many bonus shares will get? 5,000. And the shares were received on 2nd August. And I told you when we receive the bonus shares, we'll get in nominal value column. Show investment account for the half year ended. Okay, half year ended is sufficient. 30th September 2016. Keep it as it is on. Understood that, everyone?
Yes.
So now, make a format. In fact, these two transactions and values are also same. So update here also recorded. I am not writing it again. Is it shares of X Limited now? Same. Yes, right up till here. Up till here everything is same. And written up till here these two entries?
Yes, sir.
All of you? Now bonus only I have to explain you, so working note 1. Ratio of bonus shares is 1:5. On the date on which the bonus shares is declared, on 30/6/15, what are the existing shares we have with us?
25,000.
25,000. Okay. Shares on hand are 25,000. Therefore, bonus shares will be equal to
25,000
and the ratio is 1:5, so 1 by 5,000. Understood this? Now 5,000 shares at the rate of rupees, the value is 10. So what will be the value for the same?
50,000.
Any conclusions? As we discussed that bonus shares will record on the debit side only in nominal value column. Did anyone make the workings?
Yes.
So debit side the date will be 30/6/15 to bonus shares in nominal value 50,000. Where do you have? Now balance. No, the transaction is there, so 3 lakhs.
3 lakh 90,000.
3 lakh 90,000. 3 lakhs. 3 lakh 90,000. And balance also 3 lakhs and 3 lakh 90,000. Year ended 39-15, we have to make it. Half year ended 39-16. All the dates are
16.
In this question, all the dates are 16. So 39-16 by balance, head it down. Okay, we have to make it for half year ended 39-16. And there's no income, so nothing will be transferred to profit and loss account. No dividend is received in this question. Understood this, everyone?
Yes.
All of you? So, write shares, one point remains. That will take up tomorrow. Only one question remains, I think, question number 8. Right? So, that will come tomorrow. Homework, write it down. Yes, what is the meaning? 6. I gave you homework yesterday, right?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Only 8 is meaning that will finish tomorrow. Tomorrow the chapter will get over. Now see, university paper says 11 is done, right?
Yes.
12 is done, 13 is done, 14A is done.
Yes.
14B is on shares, but we'll be doing that tomorrow, the concept of that. 15A is done?
Yes.
16A?
17?
Yes. 18B is on shares. So that we'll be doing tomorrow again, that right shares point is there. 19? 20? So 20 is your homework for tomorrow. 21 we did in the class, right?
Yes.
So only question 20 is your homework for tomorrow. Okay? Tomorrow we'll complete this chapter, then only departmental accounts. One chapter will remain. Then we'll practice procedures. Bye everyone.